What's going on, guys? Well, today we're bass fishing. I'm packing our flats boat to go bass fishing. We're exploring a new area, and at this little boat ramp here, I just saw some little rabbits. They look like domestic rabbits. They might be wild rabbits, but very cool. It's very rare for me to see wild rabbits here in Florida. I know they do exist, but there's a bunch of white and black rabbits over there, so pretty cool. But I'm gonna get the boat loaded, and then we're gonna start fishing.
Hey guys, what's up? Yeah, we're fishing today for bass, obviously. We're in the C-16 canal. This is part of a huge canal system down here in South Florida, which stretches really from the West Palm Airport past Lake Ida. And Lake Ida, everyone fishes down here. But this canal is really well known. Well, not that well known, but anyway, it has a lot of fish in it. FWC says it's one of the top three canals in the county. And it's right by our house. And we figured, we want to start hitting some of these areas if you haven't fished before and just, exploring. We haven't fished here in about a year and a half. And before that, we just were shiners. So right now, I'm just kind of cruising the bank. I can see the water clarity is pretty nice. You can see right here. So we're just kind of looking for a place to fish. We're going to probably start up here at this Four Corners and just start going at it. But, we're going to be doing some methodical fishing today. Whenever you get to a new area, you're going to want to take a look at it and see what's going on. Right, Sizzle?
Right. There's a gar.
And you see, now we're seeing fish. There's a gar right there.
Oh, and there's another. There's like a little flop there.
So we'll check, So we got some life for all
of it. Holy crap, I've never seen that many fish bass fishing already.
All right, yeah, the water clarity is good. It's pretty cold. We're going to go offshore today, but we didn't for a couple reasons. One was, so Darcy, what time did we get up today?
Brian got up at 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. We said, Darcy's in charge of the alarm clock around here. And it's a nice structure. And we were supposed to get up at 7, but we got up at 9:15. Who's in charge of your alarm clock? Anyway, it's a little cold offshore, and we're babies. And in Florida, you can always go cold another day. It looks like we're dressed for being 40 degrees, but dude, it's like, what is it, 65?
It's like 60, but with northwest winds, 20 knots, makes it cold. Look at all the fish lined up there. All
right, we gotta get fishing.
Oh my God, look at the car right there.
All right, let's get to it.
First fish for me, 5 minutes in to our fishing trip, literally. And check out what I'm throwing. Oh, here we go. Woo! Chill out there, buddy. All right, he's got hooked good. All right, let me get these hooks out here. But I decided to throw this little deep diver here. And this is a Berkley, it's called a Disser. Actually, I'm gonna leave the information down in the description below for you guys. So let me get these hooks out. But I have caught some big snook on this little lure. And just decided, it's a freshwater lure to begin with, and I might as well throw it for bass. And this is deep water, there's not a lot of grass in here, so I haven't been hooking a lot of grass. So, sure enough, just hooked a nice little largemouth. I'll take it. First fish of the day. All right, let him go. Good fish. Coming in now. Woo. Oh, good one. All right. I'm using the Berkley Disser. Sorry for the airplane. Whoa, it's a good one. It's like a 2-pounder. It's a D-I-C-C-E-R. It dives down 8.5 feet, so it's a pretty big deep diver. So like I said in the description, check it out. I catch snook and bass on this lure. Nice one. Oh, he's barely hooked. Oh, nice. Oh, he just came right off the hook. Check it out. And as soon as that bait hit the water and I just, started reeling on it, getting it down deep, fish was on. So that's a nice 2-pounder, solid 2, maybe a little under. Nice fish, they're getting bigger now. Didn't think we'd be catching some peacock bass today in this cold weather, but we are catching the largemouth. I know largemouth like it when it gets cold. Sweet.
All right, so just fished this whole bank and I had an epic sequence fish bites and and hook sets, and the darn GoPro messed up, so cameraman's pretty mad. But we're heading back up the end of this thing now, and we're actually trying to troll some crankbaits through here, see how that works. Just gotta try different things in here.
Yeah, and we think the fish are some more centrally located where I first caught those first two fish this morning when we got here. So as we moved down the bank, we noticed less and less fish on the bank, and the water clarity changed slightly. So we think the fish are still back there. So we're making a move because we went along the whole bank. So we're gonna go back to where I caught fish this morning and where Brian caught a fish, but we don't have the footage. So.
Right. So again, you know, we're just trying new things in a different spot, and that kind of stinks. But I just want to let you guys know, I got my orange Salt Life Optics on today. Someone didn't like my white ones. But you know, we change the shades a lot.
But just I got my white ones.
Well, he didn't like them on guys. I don't know. No big deal.
I liked them.
Well, that's what counts, right, guys? That's the woman, Darcy likes them, and I like them, and
yeah.
None of you guys really, you know, whatever.
Salt Life Optics, these are Bal Harbour. They have all different kinds of great frames for these as well. And these lenses are also polarized, and you can see the blue lenses, so they're perfect for fishing. And his is polarized as well, and I think that's a green lens. but anyways, yeah, all right, check them out.
I'm just trying to say I traded my glasses because someone didn't like my white ones, and we got a good commercial in there. Good. Good job. I know. I did. Good job, Sizzle. But and so I guess we're just moving. And I want to mention the last video, putting Darcy on the spot here. It was our 5-year anniversary, and a lot of people are asking. What were they asking, Darcy?
Oh. What were they asking?
She's being shy. They're asking when we're getting married.
Yeah. So what? What are you asking me? All right.
No, hold on.
All right, so.
Go ahead. Now, let me tell you my part. This girl is the most wonderful girl I ever met in my life. And we all know, and I know, I ain't getting no better, right? I'm at the top of the list. So, whenever she's ready.
Yeah.
On the spot.
Bottom line is, I'm not against it, but at the same time, I'm not in any rush to get married or anything like that. And my parents went through a bad divorce, and I just have bad experience growing up with that, and I'm just not ready to get married. And we're perfectly fine and been in a great relationship for 5 years living together, you know, other than we just don't have that marriage certificate or whatever. And I don't think it's no big deal, especially in today's world. You know, I don't think I need to be rushed to get married or anything like that. And I'm still very young, and yeah, that's the bottom line, is that I'm not in any rush, but there's no, I didn't say yes or no.
Well, no, you know, so she's a woman of the current century.
I don't know.
And independent woman from a...
Yeah, like my sister, my younger sister.
Didn't have to get married.
Yeah,
no deal.
My younger sister, she's 25 and she's married. But that's like what she wanted to do. And she wants kids and family and all that stuff. So great for her. But, you know, I'm just not in any rush. The marriage thing is just not a big deal to me. I'm not one of those girls that's into the fairy tale wedding and all that great stuff. So there you go.
Yeah, and I'm not trying to say like I'm desperate to get married. I mean, you know. Hold on, fish jumped out. He's jumping up. I got the rod.
Thank you. That was funny. I just kept him in my well for a picture later on in case I catch another big one. He just popped right out.
Ah! Come on, be nice to that bass.
I didn't mean to hurt him. That was funny.
That thing jumped right out of the well. But I'm not trying to say, no, I'm not looking to say like I'm desperate to get married. I don't really, either way, it's, you know, it's no big deal to me. I'm perfectly happy, you know, we're together, and that's really what counts to me. You know, I was married before, a long time ago, and Darcy, my parents are from divorce, and Darcy's parents are divorced, so, you know, whatever. Anyway, no big deal. We're happily living together for 5 years, hopefully many more.
Yeah.
And that's the deal.
Yep. I don't need a ring to signify that.
Woo, saving money over here, boys. All right, so what I was trying to tell you guys before, my long-lost footage, is that, you know, again, Darcy and I are just going down these banks here. And over here, we got some docks, but on this other side, it was real flat and we had some banks. So we're just going right down it and casting down. And I hooked up with a fish and had a great hook set and everything. But anyway, but the other thing is, you know, when you're fishing with your friends, and Darcy and I fishing together, she's using a crankbait right now in the worm, switching back and forth, and I'm using a gambler. You know, so we're just trying different things, and it's good to have, you know, you got to make sure if you call people on a boat and you don't have everything dialed in yet, you're, you know, using different stuff so you see what works. And, you know, Darcy and I have a real good partnership doing that kind of stuff. And I love these gamblers, and they're easy for almost everywhere you go. So we're going to try and catch a fish. Thank you.
think I just saw a huge bass right there.
What?
I think I just saw a huge bass right there. Shit. It's right here. There's a huge bass right here. Or something. It's right there. The tilapia?
Bass is so dark.
You watch the back. I'm doing this. It's okay. Don't act like you were hitting the boat over there. Like you were like bracing for impact. You what? Dude? Don't curse on my camera. Jeez, Dar Sizzle.
The large
trout
might be biting, so we came
ass
out.
Ass crack
of 11
again, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, Ryan.
How you doing,
Alisa? Pretty
much.
Well,
yeah.
I actually just got this one back. I had to have a thermostat put on.
Ours is still busted.
Yeah. I don't know how that happened.
Yeah, no, I told her.
Come on. Guys, this is Lisa Potts, and they're ganging up on me because I backed the boat.
No secret.
Yeah,
no secrets.
I backed the boat into a cooler, and I broke the depth finder off.
The transducer. Anyway,
transducer. Hey guys, so we met our friend Lisa here on the water. Always nice. We're just gonna put our boat right here, and she knows some places. Oh my lord, to catch some shad. So we're gonna go down and with her and catch some shad and get some live bait and liven this party up a little bit. With some with a guest star. This is Lisa Potts, guest star. Yeah, she's a great fit, local fisherman, great local female angler, and we have a great time.
Kevin got me a GoPro for my birthday last year, and I haven't used it once, not once.
Well, this is a great boat.
But this is one I rebuilt.
You rebuilt this whole thing?
I sure did, Brian.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, it's really nice, stable too.
Yep. I rebuilt this. Actually,
look at these guys. She has rod holders like in the corner of the seat.
Everywhere.
That's pretty amazing.
Yeah.
That's a neat idea. In the back. See, this is a fisherman's boat, guys.
Too,
what, baby? This? Yeah, sure. What the heck?
Yeah, I just did some stuff on my other rebuild, and I'm waiting for it to kick. That's why I said, well, let me pop out just for a second.
This is great. And look, we got a big old.
Yep.
Bait. Well, this is what real fishermen have, guys. This is real, guys. Real stuff.
Thank you. Oh, so fancy.
Yeah, this is great.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Do you want this pole, Brian? I'm just going to get my tackle back, and that's it. You're a gambler?
You want that pole, honey? No, you don't need that.
For you.
You bought three rods.
I never have enough nail polish and enough rods.
Exactly.
Okay, enough rods.
Exactly.
I bite my nails.
All right, we're going to see if Sizzle can catch some bait here. Pressure's on. No pressure, Sizzle. We got no depth finder, so we'll see. It's a little roaring in here. Don't worry.
I don't know where the bait is, but we're just going to give it a whirl and see if we can get some.
How deep do you think it is?
Just throw it.
Look at those shed.
Oh, those are bigger than
they're monsters. All right, I guess I got to get them over there. So Lisa and I are actually talking about one of my videos, how to throw a cast net video, if you haven't seen this video already, but it's a very instructional, detailed video on how to throw a cast net, and it's the method using no teeth. And you can use it all the way up to a 10-foot net. And Lisa was saying that she watched the video and she's never been able to throw a cast net in her life. And she came out and practiced, and sure enough, she was able to pancake it on some bait, in catch bait, using my method. So it totally works. If you guys haven't seen it, we'll make sure we'll link the video here so you can go and check it out. But totally awesome and great to hear that my techniques are working for other anglers. Awesome.
Now, Lisa can teach us how to keep a boat nice and clean like this. So we do it.
Yes, yes.
Lisa
has a very pretty boat, and she does all the work herself, so it's really awesome. Our boat is not this nice.
Is this sea deck here?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's just the panels.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And that
works.
I already ordered. That was from Dar Sizzle Offshore as well. Back
Sweet.
At Christmas time.
Yeah.
When you guys put up the link.
The sea deck thing. Yep.
For the sale and.
Awesome.
I was in the middle of a demo, really.
Awesome.
On my 17 footer.
Very cool.
And I bought
probably $350 worth of sea deck for $190, I think.
Nice.
And it's in a box. I bought the ruler, a couple of helm pad, a couple of just the
You just got to put it on, right.
You know, I'll figure it out.
What up?
Don't be getting all handsy there.
Dude, I just took them down.
You stealing my shad down there? I was going to go down to Four Corners.
Let me tell you.
That, don't get out of our corner, bro.
Instead, man, they're stealing shad down there. Hey, what is this?
We didn't get any.
She just
got three.
She just threw like eight times, nothing, but she got three like snook shad.
Oh,
yeah. Shad.
Like monster
gizzard
shad.
Gizzard shad. That's what they call them?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's going out later on so he can send you the pictures.
Oh, jeez. Don't
worry about that, man. I'm going on again.
Did you get right in here?
That's Brian's favorite rod now.
Yeah.
He always wants to use Big thanks to Lisa for taking us to get some bait. So we got three shad, and I believe these are called gizzard shad. I have never caught these in my cast net before, so I wasn't really sure what the name is. So if you know the appropriate name, you can comment below. But I'm going to show you what they look like right now. So I've got three gizzard shad. I've only caught American shad in my cast net when I'm bass fishing. But these things are big, so whatever's going to eat it, hopefully is going to be monstrous. But you can see the shad right here. He is huge, which is like, I'm not used to seeing big shads like these. So I've got my little one-aught circle hook right here. I'm just going to hook them, I think just right in the nose, in between the nose right here. And I've got a float on. I'm just going to see what happens. We're going to cast around. I'm going to cast my crankbait around, and I'm going to let him just do his thing. And hopefully he catches us a big bass or a clown knife or something. I don't know if a clown knife would eat that, but yeah, that's a big fish. So throw them out and see what happens.
All right, we're throwing some massive baits around here for some monster bass. We're either going to catch nothing or a monster bass. Right, Sizzle?
Right.
See the size of those shads, man? Those big shads.
I got another fish. We had a little, we had a little lull there for a couple hours. We weren't catching any fish. Seemed like the bite shut down. And I was throwing this crankbait, you know, in the late morning, like, you know, 11, 12 o'clock, caught a couple fish on it, and then I stopped catching fish on it. So I tried the wacky worm, had no luck with that as well. I was using a watermelon red fat ace from Gambler Lures, and then also a June bug color, and I was having no luck. So this little guy just slammed my crankbait, and he's bleeding. Let me let him go. Oh my god, I got one. Fish are turning back on. Awesome. Just got another one. Bigger. Woo! Nice guy. I'm gonna say he's about a little less than the one this morning. Let me get this out of your way. They are crushing this crankbait today. Now this is like my new favorite lure to use for bass. But problem is, like, even in my backyard, there's just so much grass that I can't even, like, fish it. So here, there's not that much grass on the deep parts, so I'm able to fish it. And the fish are just crushing it. But, yeah. Berkeley Disser. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Nice little guy. And like I said, it's going down 8 feet, so these fish are just down there, and it's just reaction strikes, you know? They're just hitting it real hard. This fish hit it, and I thought I was hooked up on weed, and he was just powerful. He was able to like stay down there, but I got him. Sweet. That's four fish on the crankbait. Awesome. No fish on live bait. All right.